الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تبارك وتعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد عن حذيفة بن أسيد الغفاري رضي الله تعالى عنه قال اطلع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم علينا ونحن نتذاكر فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما تذكرون قالوا نذكر الساعة قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إنها لن تقوم حتى تروا قبلها 10 آيات فذكر الدخان والدجال والدابة وطلوع الشمس من مغربها ونزول عيسى بن مريم ويأجوج ومأجوج وثلاثة خسوف خص بالمشرق وخص بالمغرب وخص بجزيرة الأرض وآخر ذلك نار تخرج من اليمن تطرد الناس إلى محشرهم أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام Respected علماء Elders, brothers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Respected brothers, Hazrat Huzaifah ibn Usayd al-Ghifari radiyallahu ta'ala anhu has narrated, اطلع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ونحن نتذاكر. That the Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم came to us whilst we were talking amongst ourselves. On seeing that we were talking amongst ourselves, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, مَا تَذْكُرُونَ What are you talking about? We replied, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, نَذْكُرُ السَّاعَ That we are talking about Qiyamah, the last hour. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam thereafter said, إنها لن تقوم حتى تروا قبلها 10 آيات That the final hour, the day of judgment, Qiyamah will never come until you see 10 major signs appear before it. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam thereafter mentioned the 10 major signs that are to appear before the final hour. فَذَكَرَ الدُّخَانِ He mentioned the smoke that will arise and cover the whole world. وَالدَّجَّالِ The Antichrist. وَالدَّابَةَ The beast that will come out from Safa and Marwa in al-Haram al-Makki and talk to the people and show them miracles, it will have with it the ring of Hazrat Sulaiman alayhi salatu was salam, and the afah, the stick of Hazrat Musa alayhi salam. وَطُلُوءَ الشَّمْسِ مِن مَغْرِبِهَا. The sun rises from the east and sets in the west. But before the final hour, the sun will rise from the west and set in the east. وَنَزُولَ عِيسَى بْنِ مَرْيَمْ. It is the belief of the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah that Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wa salam at this very moment is alive in the heavens. And before Qiyamah, Hazrat Isa alayhi salatu wa salam will descend onto the earth. وَيَأْجُوجُ وَمَأْجُوجُ. And the coming of Gog and Magog. وَثَلَاثَةَ خُصُوفٍ خَصٌ بِالْمَشْرِكِ وَخَصٌ بِالْمَغْرِبِ وَخَصٌ بِجَزِيرَةِ الْأَرْضِ. And three landslides, one in the east, one in the west, and one in Saudiya. And the final sign, وَآخِرُ ذَلِكَ نَارٌ تَخْرُجُ مِنَ الْيَمَنِ تَطْرُدُ النَّاسَ إِلَى مَحْشَرِهِمْ. A fire which will break out in Yemen and gather the people and take the people to their place of gathering, to the mahshar. Subhanallah. We Muslims remain asleep, live the life we live, life full of defiance and disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our creator, a life full of sin, in which we have no concern whatsoever for our hereafter, in which we have no concern for Qiyamah, in which every believer and non-believer will have to pay the price of his sin. We remain asleep though these major signs are on the verge of appearing very soon. We remain asleep though Qiyamah itself is knocking on our doors. The Quran, referring to Qiyamah, says, إِنَّهُمْ يَرَوْنَهُ بَعِيدًا وَنَرَاهُ قَرِيبًا. They think Qiyamah is a long way away. They think Qiyamah is not going to come. They think the torment on Qiyamah is not going to come. They think it is a long way away. We do not think it is a long way away. وَنَرَاهُ قَرِيبًا. We think Qiyamah is very close. The final hour is very close. We remain asleep though the majority of the minor signs of Qiyamah have already appeared before our very own eyes. Didn't the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say regarding the minor signs, يَتَقَارَبُ الزَّمَانِ, that before the final hour, time will fly. Days, weeks, months and years will fly. There will be no barakah whatsoever left in time. Do we not see it today? Days are flying, weeks are going by, and yet we have achieved nothing. We are where we were. Didn't the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say that before the final hour, وَيُقْبَهُ الْعِلْمِ, that knowledge will be taken by the death of ulama. I ask you, where are the great ulama gone today? The majority have passed away. Didn't the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, وَتَظْحَرُ الْفِتَنِ, that there will be fitnas everywhere. I ask you, how many Muslims do we have in England? 1 million+, the majority of whom do not even know how to offer their salah. The majority do not even know the kalimat. The majority do not even know who the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was. Yet we have so much fitna. Everybody is claiming to be the Ahl Sunnah. Everybody is claiming to be on the Sirat al-Mustaqim, and everybody is claiming that they are the ones that will go into Jannah. Though nobody knows anything about Islam. Didn't the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, وَيُلْقَى الشُّحْ, that greed will be thrown into people's hearts. Who is content with what he has today? Didn't the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, وَيَكْثُرُ الْحَرَجْ, that bloodshed will be on the increase? Have we not seen these signs appear before our very own eyes? Didn't the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prophesy that before the final hour, zina will be on the increase, adultery will be on the increase, and people will begin to think it is halal? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said before the final hour, lying will be on the increase. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that everybody will begin to eat and deal with interest as we see today. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that people will begin to drink wine and think it is halal. They will begin to drink beer and think it is halal. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that people will begin to break relations with their own cousins. And we see this today. Neighbors will fight between each other, with one another. I ask you, have we not seen these signs appear before our very own eyes? Then we should all say, Sadaqa Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as-sadiqul masduq. How truthful the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was, that he prophesied 1400 years ago these signs, and today we have seen these signs appear before our very own eyes. Soon, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us about the major signs. We have seen majority of the minor signs appear before our very own eyes. And soon, we will see the major signs appear, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prophesied. And Allah, He Himself knows best which is the first sign to appear. But once the first sign appears, يَتَتَابَعْنَا كَمَا تَتَابُعُ الْخُرُزُ فِي النِّزَامِ, the remaining signs will follow in succession, one after the other. And inshallah, in the short time I have today, and I say short time because after 10 minutes we will all begin to look at the clock and say, hey, when is this Mulana going to come to an end? So in the short time I have today, inshallah, I am going to warn you, inshallah, of the fitna of the Dajjal, the Antichrist. The reason being, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, مَا بَيْنَ خَلْكِ آدَمْ إِلَىٰ قِيَامِ السَّاعَ أَمْرٌ أَكْبَرُ مِنَ الدَّجَّالِ, that from the creation of Hazrat Adam alayhi salatu wa salam until Qiyamah, until the final hour, there will be no matter that will arise more serious than the matter of Dajjal. This is why, مَا مِن نَبِيٍ إِلَّا وَقَدْ أَنْزَرَ أُمَّتَهُ أَلَأْوَرَ الْكَذَّابِ, or كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام, that every prophet that came, Hazrat Adam عليه الصلاة والسلام, Hazrat Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام, Hazrat Nuh عليه الصلاة والسلام, Hazrat Musa كليم الله, Hazrat Isa روح الله, and Muhammad Arabi صلى الله عليه وسلم محبوب الله, every prophet that came, he warned his ummah, he warned his nation, he warned his people about the one-eyed liar, the Dajjal and his fitna. And today, inshallah, following the footsteps of the beloved prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will warn you of the fitna of the Dajjal, the Antichrist. As the Dajjal, as you sit in this mosque at this very moment listening to me talking, Dajjal exists at this very moment. He is within the world, and he is waiting for his time to appear and cause fitna within the world. And that time will soon come. He is waiting now, as the hadith al-Jassasa, narrated by Fatima bint Qais radiallahu ta'ala anha suggests. And Fatima bint Qais radiallahu ta'ala anha qalat, سمعت منادي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ينادي الصلاة جامعة. Hazrat Fatima bint Qais radiallahu ta'ala anhu has narrated that I heard the caller, the proclaimer of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, call out, As-salatu jami'atun, as-salatu jami'atun. That kun for salah as it is time for the congregational prayer. She says, فَخَرَجْتُ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ فَصَلَّيْتُ مَعَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. When I heard the call of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam call people towards salah, I went to the mosque and I prayed my salah behind the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فلما قضى صلاته جلس على المنبر وهو يضحك. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam finished his prayer, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sat on the minbar and began to smile. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لِيَلْزَمْ كُلُّ إِنسَانٍ مُصَلَّهُ, that everyone remain in his seat. And I too follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam today and tell you all to remain in your seat. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, هَلْ تَدْرُونَ لِمَا جَمَعْتُكُمْ. He asked the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, that do you know why I have gathered you today after the prayer? Do you know why I have told you to assemble like this today? They replied, Allahu wa rasuluhu a'lam, that Allah and Allah's messenger, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, knows best why he has told us sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een to gather and sit like this in front of him today. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, inni wallahi ma jama'tukum لرغبة ولا لرحبة ولكن جمعتكم لأن تميم الدار كان رجلا نصرانيا فجاء وأسلم وحدثني حديثا وافك الذي كنت أحدثكم به عن المسيح الدجال. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to the Sahaba رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين that I have not called you today for hope or for fear. I have called you today for one reason and one reason only. I have called you today because Tamim al-Dari radiallahu ta'ala an, who was a Christian, he came and he embraced Islam. And after embracing Islam, he told me a story about the Dajjal. He narrated to me a story about the Dajjal which agrees with the account that I have given you on the Dajjal. He told me a story which is exactly like the story that I have told you about the Dajjal. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam thereafter began to tell the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een the story Tamim al-Dari radiallahu ta'ala anhu told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حدثني أنه ركب في سفينة بحرية مع 30 رجل من لخم وجذام فلعب بهم الموج شهرا في البحر. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Tamim al-Dari radiallahu ta'ala anhu told me that he embarked on a ship with 30 other people from the tribes of Lakhm and Juzam, and they had been tossed by the waves in the ocean for a month. After a month, these waves threw them to a remote island. He says, we sat in a small sideboat and entered this island. فَلَقِيَتْ بِهِمْ دَابَةٌ أَهْلَتْ كَثِيرُ الشَّعْرِ لا يدرون ما قبله من دبره من كثرة الشعر. At the time of sunset, when they entered this island, they met a beast. This beast had so much hair on its body that he says we could not distinguish its front from its back. We did not know which is its face and which is its back. because of the amount of hair this beast had on its body. On seeing this beast, we asked, "Waylak ma anta? Who are you?" He replied, "Ana al-jassasa," that I am a spy. This beast then said, "In faliku ila hadha ar-rajul fi ad-dir, fa innahu ila khabarikum bil aswaq." This beast then said, "Go to this man in the monastery. This man in the monastery is eager to know about you. He is waiting for you and he is waiting to take the information you bring." Hazrat Tamim al-Dari radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, "Lamma sammat lana rajulan farikna minha an takuna shaytana." That when this beast told us to go to this person in the monastery, we began to fear this beast, lest this be the shaytan, the devil himself. فَانْطَلَكْنَا صِرَاءً. Tamim al-Dari radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, we hurriedly went on until we entered the monastery. فَإِذَنْ فِيهَا أَعْظَمُ إِنسَانٍ رَأَيْنَاهُ قَطُّ خَلْكًا وَأَشَدُّهُ وَثَاقَةً مَجْمُوعَةً يَدَهُ إِلَىٰ أُنُقِهِ مَا بَيْنَ رُكْبَتَيْهِ إِلَىٰ كَعْبَيْهِ بِالْحَدِيدِ. When we entered the monastery, we saw a big-bodied man. Never have we seen this man before in our lives, and never have we seen such a man in our lives. This man was firmly tied up. His hands were tied to his neck, and his knees and the area between his knees and his ankles were firmly tied with chains. On seeing this man, we asked, "Ma anta? Who are you?" The man replied, "Soon you will come to know who I am. Soon you will come to know about me. But first tell me who you are and where have you come from?" Hazrat Tamim al-Dari radiallahu ta'ala anhu says, we told this man that we were Arabs, and we told this man how we got to this remote island, and we told this man about the beast that we met, and that the beast directed us to you in this monastery. Now this man, he began to ask some questions, and at the same time he began to tell him things that were going to happen in the future. He asked this group of people from Lahm and Judam, "أخبروني أن نخل بيتان." Tell me of the date trees of بيتان. هل تسمع? Do the date trees of بيتان yield fruit? Do they bear fruit? We replied, yes, the date trees of بيتان yield fruit. He said, soon a time will come when the date trees of بيتان will no longer yield fruit. No longer will they bear fruit. He asked, "أخبروني عن بحيرة طبرية." Tell me about Lake Tibariz. هل فيها ماء? Is there any water inside this lake? We replied, the lake is full of water. He said, soon a time will come when this lake is empty. Its water will disappear, and the lake will be dry, and not a single drop of water within this lake. That time will come soon. He asked, "أخبروني عن عين زغر." Tell me about the fountain of زغارة. هل في العين ماء? وهل أهلها يزرع بماء العين? Is there any water inside this fountain? And do its inhabitants irrigate with this water? We replied, the fountain is full of water, and its inhabitants irrigate with this water. He said, soon a time will come when the fountain of Zughara will have no water inside it, and thus its inhabitants will not be able to irrigate with this water. He asked, أخبروني النبي الأميين. Tell me about the prophet of the illiterate. ما فعل? What does this prophet do? We informed him that the prophet of the illiterate has emerged and he has left Makkah al-Mukarramah and migrated to Madinah al-Munawwarah. He asked, أَقَاتَلَهُ الْأَرَبُ? Do the Arabs, have the Arabs fought with this prophet? We replied, the Arabs have fought with this prophet. كَيْفَ صَنَعَ بِهِمْ? He asked, how was he treated, the Arab? We replied, he has overcome the people within his neighborhood and they have submitted themselves before him. He said, it is best for these people that they should obey this prophet. وَإِنِّي مُخْبِرُكُمْ عَنِّي أَنَّ الْمَسِيحِ. He then told these people about himself. He says, now I'm going to tell you about myself. I am the Masih. I am the Dajjal. And I am waiting for my time to appear. And soon, Allah will order me to appear. My time to appear on the face of this earth will come very soon. And once I appear, I will travel the world. And I will cause fitna and destruction in every city, every village and every town. Except for Makkah al-Mukarramah and al-Madinah al-Munawwarah. As these two places, Makkah and Medina, are haram on me. I have no permission and I cannot enter these places. If I try to enter these places, angels with swords in their hands will chase me away. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after he narrated this hadith to the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, said, Ala, hal kuntu haddathukum? O Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, did I not also tell you a story like this about the Dajjal before Tamim al-Dari radiallahu ta'ala anhum? The Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in replied, Ya Rasulullah, you also gave us an account on the Dajjal like this before Tamim al-Dari radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam pointed towards the east. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the Dajjal is in the east. So my brothers, the Dajjal at this very moment exists. And he is waiting for his time to appear on the face of this earth and cause fitna. And that time is very soon. The majority of the minor signs of Qiyamah have already appeared before our very own eyes. But how will the believers at the time recognize the Dajjal? How will we know that this place, this person claiming to be the Dajjal, is the Dajjal, the real Dajjal, the one the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and every other prophet has warned his ummah and nation of? Is it true that he has an eye in the middle of his head, as is known to the people? When will he appear on the face of the earth?